So the last few days have been laced with tragedy in the world of football. In this video, we'll discuss three of these tragedies that happened to come across my radar in the past 2 days alone. I warn you right now, this is all incredibly sad news, but I feel like I have a little bit of a responsibility to cover these things. A lot of people was tweeting these at me, and I've decided to make a video featuring all three of the stories. Now, I say this now because I know I'll get asked about it, but I do have a What Happened To video that I'm currently already in the editing phase for, and I had intended to drop that today or tomorrow, but I wanted to get this video out to kind of show my respect, so I'll push that What Happened To video to next week. And lastly, before we jump in, just let this be a reminder that if you're in good health, if your loved ones are in good health, these are things to be grateful for, as a lot of people have had a really, really tough past few days and have some really tough days ahead of them. Without further ado, you already know what time it is, fellas. Cue the wang. On July 3rd, we lost Jared Lorenzen to complications with his heart and kidneys. He'd been admitted to the hospital 6 days earlier in an attempt to get these ailments under control, but unfortunately, the former QB known as Hefty Lefty was unable to do so. Jared stood out at the quarterback position as he weighed 300 pounds as a starting college quarterback at one point. He actually still holds the record for career passing yards at Kentucky with 10,354 yards. Jared had a cannon arm and was pretty damn athletic, especially considering his size. As a high school senior, he threw for 3,400 yards with 45 touchdowns and only 6 interceptions. That same year, he also rushed for 900 yards, bro. I'd imagine it was a nightmare trying to tackle this man, and he ended up leading that high school team to a 15-0 record. After 4 years at Kentucky, Jared went undrafted in the 2004 NFL draft, but he was eventually picked up by the Giants, where he served as a backup for Eli for a few years. After a short NFL career, Jared played some arena ball, then retired from playing and did some coaching at his old high school. But that was pretty short-lived, as I guess being around the game every day, he eventually got that itch to play again. So from 2011 to 2013, he played for several different indoor football teams across a couple different leagues. Jared always had issues with his weight, literally his whole life. As a kid, his parents worked around the clock, so he and his siblings ate food that they could prepare themselves. Pizza, burgers, and anything you can microwave. He developed some really bad eating habits early on, in addition to seemingly being predisposed to being a big guy. And he ended up having a back and forth battle with his weight his entire life, despite being a professional athlete. By 2007, he'd gotten over 500 pounds and was really struggling to do normal things like play with his kids. In response to this, he decided to lose weight and document his journey, which is on the Hefty Lefty YouTube channel as we speak. In the end, he did lose over 100 pounds, but he continued to kind of have that tug of war that many people trying to lose that much weight had. He go really strict with his regimen for a while, lose a bunch of weight, and then just completely kind of fall off the wagon and gain all the weight right back. And if you know anybody who struggles with their weight, like, this is a very common occurrence, man. It's a difficult thing to get around. He'd also sustained a foot injury, which inhibited his movement, and that's a whole nother can of worms when you're trying to lose weight and you're a former athlete, but you can't be active in the same ways that you were due to injury. He had some thyroid issues and he ended up on all of these pills, and I don't know, it's tough, man. He was actually going to be teaming up with Kroger this summer for a health and wellness tour, but he ended up running into more health issues and passing away at only 38 years of age. Current Kentucky quarterback Terry Wilson is going to show some love to Jared and honor him by wearing his number 22 during Kentucky's first game of the season. It's a cool gesture, and the school itself should go ahead and have a full tribute to Jared on that day, and it'll be dope to see his number at the quarterback position for Kentucky one more time. One day after Jared's passing, two more tragedies in the world of football came across my radar. For story number two, we go from a former NFL player to a current one, Miami Dolphin defensive tackle Kendrick Norton. Kendrick was drafted into the NFL just last year in the 7th round by the Carolina Panthers. After grinding it out on the Panthers practice squad, he was actually signed last year, December 19, 2018, by the Miami Dolphins and was preparing to go into this season and, you know, try to make some noise. Unfortunately, on yesterday, he was involved in a car accident. He ended up crashing into a concrete barrier and his car flipped over. When the paramedics got on the scene to try to remove him from the car, they ended up having to amputate his arm in order to get him out of the vehicle. The good news is that his injuries aren't life-threatening, but he had to have his arm amputated, so his way of life is definitely going to be altered in a major way. And this last story takes us from the NFL to kind of the underbelly of the football world, if you will. That's junior college football. All the way back to the site of Last Chance U Season 1 and Season 2, East Mississippi Community College, EMCC. Three players who played high school ball in Mississippi Gulf Coast were headed home for the 4th of July. Zay Crane, Jeremiah Brazil, and Keon Moore. Like Kendrick Norton, they were involved in a car accident. Zay Crane sadly lost his life on impact. Jeremiah had to be airlifted from the scene to the hospital, and Keon was said to be in stable condition. So my little brother lost a friend and was badly injured in a car accident a few years ago. Similar situation to this, when they were headed home, he ended up having to be airlifted and he lost his friend in the wreck. So while I don't have a firsthand account of dealing with the situation, I've got, you know, somebody very close to me who's dealt with something similar to this, and it's unbelievably difficult to deal with, man, from all sides. So, you know, prayers go out to all of these guys, his families, man. Rest in peace to Zay, and this is something that Keon and Jeremiah are gonna have to live with over the course of their lives, man. It's not something that's easy to do. Just a crazy, tragic situation. And for Zay, man, he's gone but not forgotten, and I'm sure those that were close to him, those that loved him, they'll keep his name alive. So like I said, guys, man, send prayers out to all these guys' families, and let's all be grateful for what we have and, you know, try to enjoy every moment. That's all I got for today's video. I'll catch you guys next time. My name is Flimlo Raps. One. Yeah, I'm not no quitter, 'cause I'ma go, I'ma go, I'ma go again.